how's it gone today?
Very well. Very well indeed.
Literally flies his escort's front wheel, Henry Toivonen.
What's happened to you?
Almost too exciting. With 600 special stage miles.
We've moved up to third now.
Well, two wheels, yes.
But we hope we'll get the car sorted now.
Engine oil or diff oil?
Engine oil.
Very, very quick.
Two, one. He's an English Finn.
When you're 23 and ready to take on the best in international rallying, there's plenty of people offering advice. Don't try and win everything today. You've got plenty of time. Take it easy. For Cambria's Malcolm Wilson, there's never been enough time to do the things he set out to do in the only career that's ever interested him. That's driving a rally car faster than anyone else, regardless of nationality. With a father like the well-known and able co-driver Ken Wilson and a family car braking business, nobody was surprised when the toddler turned to cars for comfort. The surprises came when the child turned to legitimate competition and demonstrated his speed to outsiders. Now it's 1979 and Malcolm Wilson has graduated to League Division 1 of British rallying. Seven tough events in the Sedan Championship. The fastest Finns and the swiftest Swedes, besides the best in Britain, will battle over the home international title. Opening round of the Sedan Products Open Rally Championship is February's snowbound Mintex. For the organisers at De Lacy MC, it's an achievement to have staged the rally at all in such Scandinavian conditions. Getting grip, forwards or backwards, is the problem on this tough Yorkshire opener to the season. Teammate Henry Toivonen, son of 60s Monte Carlo winner Pauli, looks almost sedate by comparison. Henry had a very fine first outing in his Total Escort, quite a change from the Avengers he used to make his name in. George Hill Chevette charges through, but Wilson literally flies his Escort's front wheel at nearly 100 miles an hour. Everyone has problems on this event, the organisers trying to keep stage cancellations to a minimum, spectators trying to wriggle some life back into their toes, while competitors just want to keep going. It's not even that simple for Wilson.
No, no idea. We've been off on the last stage for over a minute, Barry, so I don't know where that's put us.
I saw you looking at the engine just now. Have you got any problems?
Just there's a slight oil leak on the distributor, but I think it'll be okay. It can be cured. It's no problem.
It's that man Hill Chevette again. He makes a sharp left, but Mike Jackson's escort slithers wide. For once, luck's on Malcolm's side, and he's through, chasing the Vauxhall and some of that elusive characteristic they call traction. With those crowds to respect and a welcome break from the snow, Malcolm heads towards a fine opening result in an event that was dominated by the Swede Stig Blomqvist's Saab Turbo. Toivonen's was an adventurous rally in the car that was driven by Kirsti Hammerleinen the previous year. After overtaking second-place man Eklund's Triumph, he has a second Forest off in Langdale that cost 3 minutes. Now he'll settle for third. And Malcolm, well, he's eighth, a valuable part of the total team that wins the team prize as well. A promising start to the season. Ireland hosts the second sedan round over Easter. Wilson shows a fantastic opening pace, setting fastest times on the first and third stages of this tarmac thriller. As they go over the border from the traditional Ulster start, Wilson keeps his lead, but the opposition behind is intense, especially from the escort of Brian Nelson, who was fastest on the second stage and very competitive in his home event. But it was an eventful first night.
Malcolm, what happens to you during the night?
Well, we started very well and then the throttle pedal broke on about the third or fourth stage and cost us quite a bit of time. And we're going to be going very well, and then we've got a puncture 7 miles from the end of one stage. We have to stop and change it. That cost us about 4 minutes, so it's dropped us fairly well down the field. We don't know exactly where we're lining up at the moment.
Because you were leading at the time, weren't you?
Yeah, so we were leading very early on, and then I think Brian Nelson got in front of us, and then I think we got back in front of him again, and it's been dodgy all the way.
The circuit is rated as one of the endurance and speed events, with 600 special stage miles of twisting tarmac. Typically, Wilson gives it all he's got. It's Ulsterman Teddy Harriman's job as co-driver to make sure his young charger doesn't give it too much. Teddy's got years of experience with names like Paddy Hopkirk and the giant killing Works Minis to fall back on. Jimmy McRae in his Chevette has got an experienced Ulsterman, Frank Main, alongside him too, and soon they're challenging Wilson for third place. Wilson keeps on attacking, squabbling vigorously with McRae and Brian Nelson over third place, and getting the better of the Irishman during the Sunday's southern stages over the demanding roads of Killarney.
So what position have you moved up to now then?
We've moved up to third now, we've quite a lead on Brian Nelson, and we're about 40 odd seconds in front of Jimmy McRae, so we've got the car all ready to go, and we're looking forward for the last section.
Though Malcolm continues in storming style, his efforts to move upfield are constantly thwarted by minor problems. Eventually lying third with 17 stages to go, a half shaft fails, forcing retirement. Cruel luck, but Wilson could head back to Britain with a new confidence. He confesses to preferring loose, forest-going to tarmac, yet here he'd shown some of the best drivers in the world what he was capable of. So, from Ireland's testing tarmac to terrain Wilson really loves, the Welsh forests, the battlefield for the third Sedan round. Again, Wilson's really flying, revelling in setting times amongst the Scandinavians.
Malcolm, you've obviously had a storming drive. You're up to second place. How's it gone today?
Very well. Very well indeed. The car's been no trouble-free. We've had an excellent day, really. We've had no punches.
Now, you're really on top of your form this season. You've done wonderfully well. What have you done since last season to improve so much?
Well, nothing really. Just kept working hard at it, and you've got to keep trying all the time and don't give in, you know. Just keep working away.
Now, you've got... you're within striking distance, comparatively speaking, of Hannu. What's your plan for tomorrow?
Well, I don't think there's much chance, really, of catching that fin, and there's another fin breathing very hard down my neck, so I don't know what's going to happen, really.
And here's that Finn, Hannu Mikkola, simply slaughtering the opposition in his Works Escort, leading by over 4 minutes and setting 20 fastest stage times. In the forest, no mistaking the Wilson style. Staccato bursts of throttle and fiery attacking wheelmanship on the fastest forest curves. For Wilson, there was a touch of, if only, about the Welsh. It had started well, and he'd been second at the overnight halt. But as the rally went from Forest to Epin's military tarmac stages, Malcolm found he was in trouble with the Escort's clutch. Gradually, he was reeled in by Brooks, and eventually had to settle for a fine third, less than a minute behind Russell's Escort. And Malcolm had beaten Toivonen, who made sixth in the other total Escort. Round four of the Sedan series sees the circus in Scotland facing an event that's always tough on cars and particularly tyres. Malcolm makes a promising start with a smart car, but punctures and consequent close encounters of the damaging kind soon alters that.
Malcolm, you started the day off in a magnificent second position and now you've slipped down the leaderboard. What's happened to you?
Well, it's a tale of war, really. To start with, the trouble is we've had eight punches in total.
Eight
punches, which is rather unbelievable. And about two stages from now, we have to stop on the stage and change away, which has cost us 3 minutes. We've lost an awful lot of time.
And I heard somewhere that you'd had half shaft trouble as well, is that right?
No, we haven't had half shaft trouble. With running with the wheels absolutely dead flat, it had broke all the calipers off, and we had to change the three handbrake calipers.
These were two wheels?
Yes, but one's done 8 miles, that one's done about 6.5 miles.
And what happened exactly?
Well, just the tyre, we deflated the tyre, and we just kept on carrying on going. And obviously the tyre comes off the rim, and then you're just left with the rim, and then it just wears down to that.
With the car healthy and puncture-free, Malcolm really motors on, even putting the mighty Mikkola behind him on some of the longer stages. He posts 9 fastest times and the same number of second and third fastest times. More important, he's satisfying his own competitive spirit and living up to the standards he's set himself, driving as fast as he can despite the deluge of punctures. But it isn't only punctures that Malcolm Wilson has to bear. The flashing lights and that engine note tell a story. Now what's the trouble? Is an outstanding performance doomed?
What's gone wrong?
One of the rose joints on the throttle linkage broke, and it was only operating on one carburetor, so we've just cruised through that.
So stage. You're running on a couple of cylinders probably, were you?
Yes, a couple of cylinders.
And how long is it going to take to fix it?
Well, I think we've got it fixed now. They're just adjusting the throttle stop, and hopefully it'll be all right again.
Do you know where you were at the time?
Well, we were up to 6th again, and we've taken quite a lot of time off Jimmy McRae, but we've had another 3 punches today already.
Restored to health again, Wilson's escort roars back into action. A spectacular sight in the typically dusty going over stones that give the car a pounding. Yes, Wilson's a really exciting driver to watch. Almost too exciting. Up she goes, but Wilson wrestles successfully for control, bouncing away to a morale-boosting 2nd overall. A terrific result for Total's talented wheelman in his first Premier League season. The only event in the sedan season to allow practice and pace notes, the Mopar Manx packs 250 competition miles, mainly over closed public roads, into 2 hard days and a night. Even Wilson confesses to finding the speeds a bit scary. It's all so solid.
The car is unfortunately not handling very well, and we've problem with an oil leak, and we've lost all the oil. But we hope we'll get the car sorted now.
Engine oil or diff oil?
Engine oil, yeah, and it's coming onto the tyres, which is making it slide about a lot. And it's causing quite a problem.
What's caused that?
We don't know yet, but we're trying to find out at the moment. I think the lads will cure it.
Well, now, you're well up.
We've lost time, actually. We've got some road penalties at the moment because we had to go and get some oil because the car used about 3 gallon.
Oh,
so
cool.
We dropped some road penalties, so it'll have dropped us back quite a way now.
His car revived, Malcolm literally leaps back into contention, fighting for 3rd place with McRae's Chevette and Brooks in the escort. But soon Malcolm's luck is out. The steering breaks after they've covered just over half the competitive mileage. More closed public road, but this time we're back in Ireland for the Ulster, round 6 in the sedan series. The Total Twins are back. Malcolm is fast, while Henry Toivonen is also all fired up, practicing to be a road widener. But the Ulster is a brief outing for both men. Toivonen goes off on the 2nd special stage, and Wilson doesn't last much longer.
Well, what happened there, lads?
To be quite honest, I can't tell you. There's just a right-hand bend on the last stage, and we were halfway around it, and then all of a sudden the car just went sideways into the bank, and it appears as though it's bent the axle. The car's weaving all over the road now, so unless we can get an axle, we're out of the rally.
You're looking very cheerful about the whole thing.
Not really, but nothing we can do.
What are they going to do now then?
Well, I think they're going to try and straighten it.
Okay. Go on, more heat on it.
Just hold it from this end. Keep on this end.
But it's all in vain, and eventually Hanneman takes the inevitable decision.
Forget it.
Don't put any more of that in it.
Forget it.
Wilson wonders if things really can get worse. To keep his eye in during 1979 and accept a challenge, Malcolm is trying to become the first man to win the Castrol Autosport National Rally Championship for the 2nd time. The last round is the Bovis National, held in the Forest of Dean.
So, Malcolm, how do you fancy chances then?
Well, obviously, we're not going to go for an outright win. We're going to have a nice, steady run, and, you know, as long as we finish 3rd, we can win the championship, so as long as we have a nice, steady run, I think that'll do.
This is taking it steady, Malcolm Wilson style. At lunchtime, Malcolm was leading McRae by 26 seconds. From stages 11 to 14, Wilson set fastest times, including the classic Speech House stage. Malcolm Wilson, 1978 Castrol Autosport National Rally Champion, becomes Malcolm Wilson, 1978 and 1979 champion. A champion who's won his way to the top with victories on all but three of the qualifying events. It's been tough trying to break into the Sedan Championship, but Wilson says the National Series has been just as important as it's given him time to develop his driving style. Well, he certainly earned a drink at the Ross on Wye Hotel finish. Sutton Park, late in November. For any driver, the RAC rally is the big event. For a Briton, it's particularly important. For Wilson, there's the pride of being a top 10 runner amongst the best in the world, here to contest this prestigious penultimate World Championship round. But sadly, the folly stages of Wales are Malcolm's betrayer. He loses sixth place overall when the escort is reluctant to rejoin the fray after a spin on the last morning. He finishes outside the top 10, but happy at the close of a year where the store of experience and success that's so vital in rallying has been carefully nurtured. A year that includes five national victories and a second on an international deserves toasting. The English Finn will be back, thirsting for more.